Yo, what's going on? You're tuning in to another Mario Ramon review, and today we're going to review The Real Housewives of Atlanta. Let's get to it. New season. I think this is actually season 13, episode 2. They introduced the new girls tonight. Let's talk about this shit right here and right now. But I have to shake something really quick, if you can excuse me for a moment. To the left, to the right, come on. To the left, to the right, double. Right, look like you don't know they looking at you. Double. Y'all so crazy. What's going on, Boo Bears? What's going on? Alexa, pause. Okay, so we're talking about The Real Housewives of Atlanta. This new show is called The New Peach and the Orchard. But there's two new peaches in the orchard. So we have new Tanya, which is too close to Tanya, which we should all call Tanya Tanya anyway, because it's the same thing. Water and wet, same thing. But we have Tanya now in town, and she's stirring the pot. That's why, you know, she's being represented. We ain't seen Tanya yet, and she's one of our main girls. We ain't seen her yet because you don't stir the pot. You always have, you know, kitchen mittens on. Honey, sometimes you got to burn your hand, Tanya. Get in there. Come for Kenya, honey. Don't be scared to come for Kenya. Come for this bitch. She gonna come for you. She's coming for you if you come for her or not, so you may as well come for her. Okay? Secure your peach. They're like, we are not gonna give you a peach. You cannot get a peach being tan. Okay, so, and we found that out real easily. But we have Tanya, and we also have, what's the new girl? Drew. Let's get into Drew. Okay, the only thing I want to say that I picked up on Tanya is I feel that she's a mean girl. Like, she's very, very pretty. She's stunning to look at. Face, mug, all that shit is beat. I just think she's a mean girl. Like, her demeanor is mean and abrupt, like when they were on the patio. I think she came for Cynthia a little too soon. Is that an artificial plant? Bitch, it's in a bought home, honey. It's artificial in a paid-for home on the lake. Shit, honey, you just barely got in the door. Okay, so don't have me escort your ass out, bitch. Don't come for my plants. And then, now, Cynthia did need her ass whooped when she had those fake grapes. I've never seen that one myself. Now, that I've never seen. She had fake grapes as garnish. I know we're in the middle of COVID, but the Publix has to be about 2.5 miles away. Go get you some grapes from Publix, wash that shit off, and then put them on the dish, honey. But never will we ever do fake grapes again, especially if you're inviting Kenya Moore to your house and you have fake grapes, bitch, you're asking for it. You are asking for it. That's like you walk up to Mike Tyson and you spit in that big motherfucker's face. What the fuck? Oh my goodness, honey. You better be in a motherfucker on a motorcycle, honey, if you do this shit, because if you're on foot, Mike Tyson gonna catch you and kill you. I could not believe it. She had fake grapes with the food. And then to add insult to injury, LaToya said, oh, I love cold meatballs. Then go over that motherfucker in the corner and eat them, bitch. Because once again, but whoever made the cold meatballs do need their ass whooped, especially if you walking around here parading like you have this assistant. And he's not your assistant because Kenya is your friend, and Kenya came in and she said, oh, who are you? So this shit is a facade. It's all for TV. Stop playing with me. He's a server for the day. He was serving you guys the cocktails. Assistants don't serve cocktails. They sit back and go get dry cleaning and shit. You need some tissue. You need some maxi pads. You need some condoms. You need a little weed. You know, the assistant go get that shit, honey. Whitney Houston can't be caught driving around. Hey, y'all got a 20 bag. I'm just saying. Of some weed, you know? So that's what the assistant's for. I have never seen an assistant like go over there. Like, he was a server out of work due to COVID. I mean, I'm not hating on his hustle. I'm not hating on your hustle. But I got server out of work for COVID. Hey, Miss Cynthia, come on. You should let me on the show and I can be your friend or something. And she'd be like, honey, you're not going to be my friend. Like, why would I have, like, everybody knows my friends. But you could act like you're my assistant for the day. 2 plus 2 is 4, even when you're counting pesos, pumpkin lamb. Because if Kenya is your friend and Kenya came to your house and Kenya didn't know who the hell he was, I know of my best friend, I came to his house, I'd be like, oh, who are you? I'm Richard's assistant. I'd be like, child, what is going on around here? What is going on around here? So, like I said, I think Toya is just a little mean. I think she is. And even if she's not, prove me wrong. I think Drew is a sweetheart. But that shit, her husband got them stomped. All that shit. This is what he got for that anniversary. He gave it to me for the anniversary. He was nice. And I was on his side. And her husband came to the lake house with her. So Drew comes to the lake house with this. Okay, so Drew, I love you. And I think you're a pretty girl. And there's just two things, honey. Don't pick up where Giselle left off. Don't pick up where Giselle left off, like being the worst dressed on TV. That dress may have even been real, but it just wasn't. Number one, it wasn't in 2020. It's not a 20. It wasn't a 2019, 2018, or 2020. It was not in that collection. I can guarantee you. And I'm not reading. But I'm just saying. Come on now. You're giving. Okay, so imagine this. You're on the cast of The Real Housewives, okay? So imagine being on the cast of Sex and the City. Did they play with you in the movie? No, bitch. This is entertainment. We don't have time to be shooting. You got one shot and the bear's coming at you, bitch. Shoot that motherfucking shot. I don't have time for you to get it together for next season. I don't have time for this shit. Go rent some clothes. That confessional outfit with that big ass Patti LaBelle fake ass ring looking like a bowl. Come on, man. Them earrings screaming, fake, fake. Them bitches was like, fake, I'm fake, I'm fake. Like, stop, I'm gonna fuck you up, allegedly. I love you. Okay, so listen, if I see you, let's have a cocktail and talk about it. I don't want you getting mad and shit. I'm telling you this for your own good. You need me as a gay friend. You know what I'm saying? They help you out with shit like this. And I say it in love. Okay, now. Let's talk about the husbands. When Cynthia's husband and then Drew's husband, Ralph, was walking to that beach house, I said, it is a ass festival. They had an ass festival. It must have been 40 pounds worth of ass between the both of them. And then, so that was that. And then, you know, when he went down to the lake house and he was telling, y'all so crazy for laughing at that. Y'all are crazy. But it was an ass festival. Now, tell the truth, shame the devil, honey. That cameraman was like, yippee. That motherfucker was singing them old Shirley Temple songs. I'm a good ship, lollipop. And he was pointing that motherfucking camera down. I saw you, old nasty cameraman. He was an old nasty cameraman. And he was a nasty cameraman when he zoomed in on Portia Baby's hair, too. I caught it. It was, you know, I caught it. Because I know what these cameramen be doing. Y'all better catch that. So then the two men, you know, the husbands, Ralph and Mike Hill, they went down on the lake and they're talking. And then Ralph shares this information that he had to leave the house for 3 days. Okay, I get it. You have to leave the house for 3 days. Let's go straight into their anniversary dinner. Number one, it's your anniversary. So two things. I feel, number one, we should not have had this discussion on our anniversary on camera. So it could be recorded and syndicated. And this is how marriages break up, bitches. Which one is more important? Being on the Housewives of Atlanta with fake ass jewelry on? Or your husband that got balloons and shit. When you walk outside, you acting like you surprised. You didn't hear all this ruckus out here with fucking balloons being brought in your house. And the chef is here. You smell that shit downstairs. Oh my God. What's going on? Bitch, you can smell and hear. Stop playing with me. But I kudos to her husband for doing something like that, you know? So I just didn't feel that particular conversation was for this time. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't wear a bathing suit at a wedding and you don't wear a wedding gown on the beach. So there's a time and place for everything. So I don't feel that conversation should have been on their anniversary dinner, number one, and on film. Number two, on the flip side of it all, I can see where she's coming from where, listen, we haven't talked about this, and I cannot sit down and have this dinner with you and you don't tell me where the fuck you were for 72 hours. It's this huge secret. Like, it's the secret, like, you know, the fucking pyramids. Who helped with the pyramids, bitch? It's one of the wonders of the motherfucking world at this point. And I was getting pissed off watching it. I was like, what's the fucking problem? Tell her where you are. Where were you? Why is it so hard to tell her where you were? Look, see, that will get your ass snatched. I was with her at that point because at first I was like, you know, there's a little nagging going on. But on the flip side, she was fucking valid. She was valid. What difference does it make if I know? If you did not know where your wife was for 3 days and you didn't care. So it's the first we got to get through the you don't know where your wife is. For 3 days, how would you like that? And you don't know where she is for 3 days. And then you're talking about, I went to a beach and all this. And that very well may be so. But there is a way to do it. Like I said, there is a way to do it. You are wearing a two-piece bathing suit at a wedding at this point. It's just all wrong. It's all wrong. And you tell your wife where you're going. Hey, babe, I'm going to go to so-and-so beach for 3 days. I need to clear my mind. But I'm going to tell you the tea. He was so hot. With Mama Drew. I know this, allegedly. Now, this whole part of this next story is alleged. In my opinion, Ralph was so hot with some shit that Mama Drew said that popped off, Drew's mother. And she's acting like her name is on the house note, on the deed. No, you are the mother. And you are supposed to be neutral and tan and be a peacemaker. You, and Drew, get that in order. This is why y'all having problems, because I saw on the film, she's arguing with him and he's like, we need to do the work, da, 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 da. And they don't need to be having a conversation. Mom, this is my husband. Now, you are my mother, but you are not in the master bedroom. Everybody in the master makes the motherfucking rules. Now, I wouldn't say motherfucking to my mother, but you will be able to see it in my eyes. Do not try me and do not try my husband in this roof. Are we clear? I don't want to hear that shit. I don't even want to hear that shit. I don't want to hear it. Go tell that shit to somebody else who cares. I don't care. You are not going to come up in here and disrespect our home. And we got 5,011 children running around here. We good and married. This ain't no shit that just happened like 60 days ago. We good and motherfucking married. And we're trying to make it to a decade. Fucking with you, we not gonna make it. You in here yelling at my husband and shit. We in COVID and shit. I'm gonna have you on an Amtrak train with a mask on your face going back home. See, Drew, you gonna let the show and your mom fuck your marriage up. And then he gonna be gone. And then you gonna be like, damn, I wish I had that dick again. Somebody else gonna have it. You better snap out of it. Don't you lose your husband for some bad outfits and fake jewelry, faking in front of us. It's not worth it. Now, let's move on. I'm proud of Portia. Her mother looks good. Her sister looks good. Okay, that's it. Look like Portia had a lip injection or two, just a small one at the top lip. That ain't not how that lip looked last season. So stop playing with me. Portia, leave your face alone. You're beautiful. You cute. Stop it. Stop it. Everybody is thicker than the Snickers on the show. It's good, though. That's what black men want to see. But Bravo is not marketing towards black men. Y'all better listen. Come on now. You already know. They're going to put somebody half your age on and pay them half. Pay them half because y'all done worked your way up here. But, honey, you already know the game. Shit, that shit didn't happen to Katherine Hepburn. All the motherfuckers, honey. What's her name? Mommy Dearest? Who played Mommy Dearest? Joan Crawford? They were like, no, bitch. You're not doing it in front of the camera anymore. I'm just saying, y'all got to look at this shit like it is a fucking job. It is a job. And you got to do what you need to do. And if you a model on the runway, I'm not trying to be funny. Can you pick up 30 pounds and do your job? If you're a police officer and you have to run and chase people, can you? I'm not shaming or no shit like that. I'm just saying this is what's up for your job. If you're a boxer, if Mike Tyson picked up 30 pounds while he's boxing, you cannot. You have to stay cognizant. Keep your eyes on the prize, honey lamb. Kenya, I know, she going through that shit with Mark, honey. It's a wonder she didn't gain 90 pounds. Kenya says she was 188 pounds. Well, she makes 188 pounds look damn good. Because I thought Kenya was probably about 150 or 60 on the camera, you know, on the TV show. So if she's 188, she makes it look damn good. She makes it look damn good. That whole party, the wine tasting, was just Shady McGrady. It should have been called the Shady McGrady party. Welcome in the two girls. And like I said, Toya was just being a little mean to me. Did nobody have on no mask? They didn't even talk about it. And I know we're in quarantine and everything, but you have to talk about it for the viewers, because some people, they just not smart. And they like, well, honey, if Portia going to the party without a mask on, I'm going to the party without a mask on. I'm just saying. She's not my role model, but she is somebody's role model. Honey. Okay. Congratulations, Riley. Oh my God, that is a beautiful baby. She is beautiful. When Candy came to pick up Mama Joyce, and Mama Joyce came out in that beautiful outfit. I love the outfit, but I thought about that Mama Joyce wig when Kenya told Sheree. She said, well, you got on that Mama Joyce wig. And ever since then, I was just like, please, Mama Joyce got to get a different wig. She has to get a different wig, because that's all I think about. Because Sheree did have on a Mama Joyce wig. No tea, no shade. I love her. I love you, Candy. Don't get mad at me. But she did. She did. She had on a Mama Joyce wig. I thought that was weird when Drew said her husband, Ralph, records them at home and didn't tell her that they were being recorded. I'm like, that's some Silence of the Lambs shit now. You trying to drive my woo-woo up? I ain't gonna give you none. I think you a damn freak. You're weird. She was like, and then he went in her phone and deleted it, which is extra guilty. Motherfucker, are you kidding me? Oh, I have one word. I don't wish this, but it appears like they're both sweet people, but they have some growing up to do. I pray they can do it together. I pray they can do it together, because this right now is looking doomed. This is our introduction of it all. And then you can see things, you know. I don't care even if this is a storyline and everything. When you personally see, like when you're on these shows and you personally see it again, it opens up each and every time. And you can both have healed some shit, and it could be 5 months later, and then they're playing the marathon, and you eating some cereal, and you see this shit, you get pissed off again. And it could fuck up your relationship. I ain't got time for this. And it make you, you know, it can make him really dislike your mom when he sees it. And, you know, because in life, you don't see it being replayed over and over again. But here, you see it being, you know, in syndication. So, you know, but I'm telling you this, Drew. Get your mom home. Wherever she lives, she don't live that far away. She does not live in Japan. Get her home, honey. If you ain't got to get across no motherfucking water to get her there, get her there. Take that one good foot and drive your mother where she need to be driven. And honey, I don't know, play a good CD, bitch. I don't know who's out, but play a bitch. Play a new bitch. Play an old bitch. I don't care. Summer Walker. Somebody. Congratulations, Summer Walker. I heard you're pregnant, pumpkin lamb. Okay, so I think that's it. Cynthia, warm your meatballs up. Quit putting fake. You're just not a host, honey. And you got the Bailey Agency. I'm scared about it. I'm scared that these aren't your intuitions. You know what I'm saying? And don't be side-eyeing me like, what do you know? It's a honey, I know how to make a hot meatball and not to put no fake grapes as garnish. Now, and when Kenya's coming. Out of all people. Kenya and Nene. And Nene would have lit your ass up too. And I like you. I like you. Your hair was coming from your roots this whole show, Cynthia. The hair was coming from your motherfucking roots. My friend was over. He said, that's a wig. I said, snap out of straight man mode now. Shit, you're gay. Snap out of it. You should know these things. I'm asking you, could you know about these things? Wait, is there anything else I forgot? I don't like. Oh, when LaToya told Drew, she was like, I don't like you. And I really thought, baby, I'm almost finished, baby. Oh, no. I'm saying I'm almost finished because we got to watch The Real Housewives of Potomac. And I got to do the review on it. Okay? So I don't want to prolong, you know. But when LaToya told Drew, I don't like you. That's why I don't like you. And I was like, here comes some shit. And then Drew did too. She drank that goddamn champagne so fucking fast, honey. Your head will spin. She was drinking it so fast. She was like, so I can deal with this bullshit. What is she going to give me? And my foot hurt. I can't hop up and pop off. But she handled it good. Both ladies handled it good. Like I said, okay, so I just like, let's just go over this one time. Kenya's dress she had on, first of all, it was I was going to say a boob convention, but it was a titty convention. Do you hear me? Everybody who had them showed them, honey. And Candy, here come Candy. Shit, I got some new ones too. Shit. Candy was showing hers in her confessional. Kenya was showing hers at the party, and Cynthia, she never stopped showing hers. She be like, shit, she just, one day I'm just going to see Cynthia's confessional and she ain't going to have nothing on from the waist up. She going to have on the Eve collection. Just skin and maybe a little tape, honey. I'm just waiting on it. They love showing their boobs. Here they are. Hear me roar. Honey, I'm 50 and I'm 51. And here I got some boobs. Look at them. NeNe, too, last season, walking through the hotel. Don't nobody want to see that, NeNe? You're going to fuck around and blind me, honey. Oh, my God. Don't have me touch my imaginary pearls, NeNe. Now, Jesus of Jerusalem, Nazareth, and Bethlehem, NeNe leaks. She's showing Greg's titties all in the room. And they was like, cover your titties. You're like, you seen them before. That's not the point, bitch. I don't want your titties to turn me like Medusa be turning bitches into stone, bitch. You fuck around and see one of Aunt NeNe's titties and it. You done fucked around and turned into stone, bitch, looking at this girl's titties. Well, listen, guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me on the Mario Ramon Review, Real Housewives of Atlanta. We have to watch The Real Housewives of Potomac, and then I'm going to do the review on that. So don't forget to catch the review of The Real Housewives of Potomac. And reunion, actually. This is The Real Housewives of Potomac reunion. But thank you so much for hanging out. Don't forget to comment. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel. And after you subscribe, click the bell so it can notify you that I have new videos coming out, and comment. And thank you so much for hanging out. I appreciate you. Okay, so let's do our dance. Alexa, continue. Continue song. Alexa, repeat song. So that's I Saw You Walking in the Rain. And the reason I played that is because how Ralph was videotaping Drew and her family and her mom and all that. And why are you videotaping the house? And even if you are, it's okay, dude. Just let a girl know, hey, babe, I'm going to be videotaping the house. You know what I'm saying? Just in case there's some intruders or anything. But just don't be videotaping the house. And I don't know, because that's freaky as fuck. And don't be trying to leave for 72 hours because now I think you have a side piece. You got too much ass in back of you to be leaving for 72 hours and I don't know where you are, period. And she was like, well, when you leave, I don't ask where you going, bullshit. Which Ralph's are you going to? The one on Abernathy or the one on 10th Street? Fuck that bitch. You better be a forensic specialist. And you in Atlanta too, bitch. Now, if you were in Milwaukee all day. Okay, baby, I'll see you when you come back. Atlanta, what time you coming back and where you going to be? I don't have time for half that shit you talking about, bitch. Your husband got an ass festival in back of him, honey. And them boys in Atlanta, I'm just saying. I'm not saying he is, but honey, you better listen to your uncle. I'm not saying he is. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying where you live. It's kind of like let me give you an example. Because I don't want you to think I'm trying to disrespect you, because I'm not. It's anything but that. You need to sit down with me and have a coffee or a tea and learn how this shit works. Don't sit down on it. What I'm saying is this. If you cut your hand or your finger or your wrist, or if you cut yourself, you cannot jump in the ocean because sharks are going to be after your ass and piranhas. Meaning men and women. Now, I ain't say he's into men, but men will be into him. And women are going to be into him. And now he's on this show, and they know y'all are having problems and shit, and you airing all this shit on him. It is going to be a free-for-all. Do you hear me? He's not going to be able to go to a motherfucking 7-Eleven. Ooh, I saw you. I like your show. Ooh, those balloons were cute you did for your wife. How y'all doing? I heard y'all was having some problems. Well, if you ever want to talk here, I'm a realtor. Here's my card. Oh no, you can call me, honey. You can call me on my cell phone. Okay, so that's what I'm saying. Then he gonna be missing for 3 more days, bitch, and I don't have time for that. When you be leaving, I don't ask where you are. The devil is a motherfucking lie, honey. I mace and tase the devil, bitch. I ain't got time for it. I'll mollywop him. Okay. I'll see you guys next time on the Mario Ramon Review. Happy Sunday. Don't forget to pass the video on to your friends if they watch the shows that I do the reviews on. And I thank you so much for hanging out with me. Peace.